Probably the easiest case would be when the two countries are exactly equal. So if this dot equals other country, then I can immediately return 0. Otherwise, if this dot area is less than other country dot area, I want to return a negative number. I'll just go with -1. Otherwise, if this dot area is less than, I mean greater than, other country dot area, I want to return a positive number. I think 1 will do. Otherwise, their areas must be exactly equal, in which case I'll use the string compare to method on the name and return the result of that. Once I fix my syntax errors, I want to check that this actually works the way I'd expect. So I'm going to get out my codepad and make some new countries. El Salvador should come before Belize. So if I compare El Salvador to Belize, I should get a negative number. So far, so good. Certainly the opposite direction should be positive, and Belize compared to Belize should give me 0. And just to make sure that I'm breaking ties, let's compare Belize to a made-up country with the exact same area. All right, negative 11 sounds good to me. So long as compare to doesn't return 0 with two countries that are clearly different countries. Now, to make sure the work wasn't all for nothing, I want to show you that now we can sort all of the Central American countries using the arrays.sort method. Now, if I run this, and I've tampered with the two-string method a little bit just to make this easier to see, I get the countries in order by their areas. Sorting is actually an interesting task, one many people have studied for years, but we just managed to do it in one line of code. Hooray for interfaces!